have carved our names in the trunk of this tree. Farewell, my Lila, I miss you already, and dream of the day when I'll hold you again in a home safe from fear. When the Southland is free, I go to fight for these old hills behind me, these old red hills of home. I go to fight for these old hills. The truth that must endure in a town called Marietta, in the old red hills of home. Pray on this day as I journey beyond them, these old red hills of home. Let all the blood of the North spill upon them till they've paid for what they've wrought, taken back the lives they've taught, and there's peace in Marietta, and we're safe again in Georgia, in the land where honor lives and breathes, the old red hills of home. Farewell, my Lila.
They called me to tell it, the lives that we led when the Southland was free. We gave our lives for the old hills of Georgia. Survives of the old hills of Georgia, but I close my eyes and hear all the treasures we held dear. The rushing of the Chattahoochee, the rustling in the wind.
Yeah! terrible degradation, but never defeat. The men of Georgia and the women of Georgia have never
I go
been
to bed
defeated.
At night, hoping when I wake, this will all be gone like it was just a dream, and I'll be home again, back again in Brooklyn. Back with people who look like I do, and talk like I do, and think like I do. But then, the sun rises in Atlanta again. These people make me tense. I live in fear they'll start a conversation. These people make no sense. They talk and I just stare and shut my mouth. It's like a foreign land. I didn't understand that being Southern's not just being in the South. When I look out on all this, how can I call this home?
I am proud to be a Georgia.
These men belong in zoos. It's like they've never joined civilization. The Jews are not like Jews. I thought that Jews were Jews, but I was wrong. I thought I would be fine, but 4 years down the line, with every word it's very clear I don't belong. I don't cuss, I don't draw, so how can I call this home? Calls, and I'm free of the southern breeze, free of magnolia trees and endless sunshine. Evermore lives the dream of Atlanta, but not mine, not mine. A Yankee with a college education, by his own design, is trapped inside the land that time forgot. Trapped inside this life, and trapped beside a wife who would prefer that I said howdy, not shalom. Well, I'm sorry, Lucille, but I feel what I feel, and this place is real. So how can I call this home?
Well, hey, sunshine.
Sunshine, looks like rain to me.
Not in here, it don't.
Frankie Epps, quit that.
Oh, can't... what? I ain't doing anything. Gonna go to the picture show, there's a movie I got to see. You know the one called The Silver Gun? Well, I've been watching since chapter 3. I can't wait, it's at 8, but I was wondering if you're free.
Go on, go on, go on, go on. You know my mama never let me till I turned 16. Go on, go on, go on, go on. Besides, I only go to pictures that I haven't seen.
Well, when do you turn 16?
2 years from next June.
Too bad about your mama.
Too bad for you.
I know a spot near McConnick's lot where you can see the parade real clear.
Mm-mm.
I got a book you want to take a look. It's called The Thief and the Brigadier. I got gum, you want some?
Haven't chewed gum for a year.
Go on, go on, go on, go on. I bet your mama let me take you to the picture show.
Go on. I'm sure and read a listening when I said no. When I asked I own the stover, her mama lets her do whatever she wants.
I was hoping I could go with you.
Go on, ask I own the stover, her mama lets her see whoever she wants.
Well, maybe I will.
I hope you do.
Hey, where are you going?
To the factory. I didn't get my pay this week.
Okay, see you around.
At the picture show.
What? I thought your mama wouldn't let you.
She will with Essie and Betty Jean, just not with you.
Bye, sunshine. Day, 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 go on, go on, go on, go on. Well, Iola, you going to the pictures tonight?
I am trying to remember. I was checking around the factory, and I went into the basement, down the stairs into the basement, and I shined my light around here in the corners of the ceiling. And I'm about to check the washroom, in my lighted colored couches on a pile of rags in the middle of the room.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Do you know who this is, Mr. Frank?
Oh my God, it's the little girl I paid yesterday. She came up to my office.
I ain't seen no pile of rags there before, so I go and I kick it, and I shine down my light, and Lord, Lord, ain't no pile of rags at all.
Who did it? Do you know who did it yet?
The small white body with the tongue sticking out, this pretty little child with eyes wide open.
Oh, no, you don't think it was my night watchman, Newt? Newt Lee, do you think it was Newt?
So I ran to the phone and I called Mr. Frank, but the phone kept ringing, so I called y'all to help me. Mr. Frank, he didn't answer, and that's all I can remember.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, you think I... You think... That's absurd. It's preposterous. I didn't even know this child. I only remembered her name because she was in my office yesterday.
Excuse me?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm hoping you can help me.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, my daughter didn't come home last night.
Can I have your name, please, ma'am?
Fascinating, scintillating, stimulating, spirit-stirring week. Big news, another Sunday comes to Atlanta. Another week of news so thrilling that your average city news hound wants to take a flying jump into the creek. You got a kitten up a tree, well, come to me, and I'll see it makes it on the front page. The mayor's mother broke a toe, they gotta know. Stop the press, it's a mess, it's a scandal of the age. Hell, it's big news, another shock to rock. Atlanta, another information feast. From the gateway to the whole southeast. Look in the mines and the mills and the Mexican hills. They've got stories to tell. Look, now Ohio's afloat. Soon the women will vote and we'll all go to hell. Look, now that Wilson is in and old Taft didn't win. Hell, they're coming to blows. Look, the Titanic went down, but I'm stuck in this town with my thumb on my nose. And that's big news, another stir-crazy freak in Atlanta. The Board of Estimates approved a new street. Yippee! They're building churches out of high-grade concrete. Look at that! They say the rain will give a break from the heat. It's a scoop, it's a twist, it's a reason to exist. Pray to heaven, pray to Zeus, there's a genius on the loose. In the gateway to the whole. What a town! Arrived by Intel. situation's never been so strong. Big news, my career has been revived. All I needed was a snippet, pissy Yankee all along. Take the superstitious city, add one little Jew from Brooklyn, plus a college education and a mousy little wife. And big news, real big news, that poor sucker saved my life. So give him fangs, give him horns, give him scaly hairy palms, have him drooling out the corner of his mouth. He's a master of disguise, check those bug out creepy eyes, show that fella's gonna rape the whole damn South. They'll be banging down my door, yelling, "Ma, Greg, Ma, call for justice, Winnie, justice, beat the bastard, kill the bomb." Big news, real big news, my savior is finally gone. Obtained exclusively by this reporter, prosecutor Dorsey has the villain in his sight. A highly ranking unnamed source in this investigation tells me Leo Frank's the only likely culprit in this case. Anyone with any information on the suspect Leo Frank should contact this reporter, care of the Atlanta, Georgia.
I saw this little kid, said look what Leo did, and then she run and hid.
Go on, go on, go on, go on now. Just scribble it down and it covers the town like molasses or mud. Look, for us drunken old bums, opportunity comes in a magical flood. Look, you might never be sure if your motives are pure, but your profits are clear. Look, you were down and depressed, now you're right in the crest of the scoop of the year.
Jim Conley, I got a piece of paper here that says you spent a lot of time on the chain gang.
That right?
Twice, according to this. And the second time it says here you were out with the road gang and you just up and disappeared.
Well, you know my term was about up.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I think you had a few more months to serve. You know what that makes you, don't you?
Lucky?
I was gonna say an escaped convict. Now, what should we do about that?
What was that you was asking me about, Mr. Frank?
Stories, these contemptible conceits, and you say you understand how a man's heart beats, and you don't know a thing. You don't know this man. You don't even try. When a man writes his mother every Sunday, pays his bills before they're due, works so hard to feed his family, there's your murderer for you. And you stand there spitting words that you know aren't true. Then you don't know this man. He is an old anyone who knows him. Not a morsel, not a crumb, not a clue. I have nothing more to say to you.
Gentlemen of the jury, and good people of Georgia, there is a farmhouse in Marietta, kind of battered and forlorn. And in that farmhouse, 14 years ago, a girl named Mary was born. And she would dance in fields of cotton. There was a tree where she could play. But when her daddy died 2 years ago, Mary and her mama moved away. It's only 20 miles from Marietta to a factory in the center of this town. And 20 miles was all it took to strike that sweet girl down. People of Atlanta fought for freedom to their graves, and now their city is a factory, and their children are its slaves. People of Atlanta swing their city gates wide, and look at what you've wrought!
So, Frankie, you say you rode downtown with Mary on the English Avenue streetcar?
Yes, sir, morning of the Memorial Day parade.
And can you tell us what happened?
Well, she got up to go, and she looked kind of funny, and I said... Something wrong, Mary?
Mr. Frank.
Mr. Frank what?
Looks at me.
Looks at you? Everybody looks at you.
Not like Mr. Frank.
What's he do?
He calls my name. I turn my head. He got no words to say. His eyes get big, my face gets red, and I want to run away. And he looks, and I wait, and he smiles.
Ola Stover, will you describe for the court Mr. Leo Frank's manner in the factory?
Mrs. Fagan, can you describe for us, please, ma'am, the outfit your daughter Mary wore to town last Memorial Day?
Was her Easter Sunday outfit. A little lavender cotton pongee dress I made her. Straw hat with a parasol to match. White stockings. And her party shoes.
Would these be the clothes?
My child will forgive me for raising her poor and for taking her out of the school. My child will forgive me for not doing more to protect her from men who are cruel. And my child will forgive me for closing my eyes till the dangers are growing too fast. My child will forgive me with tears in her eyes when we're reunited at last. My child will be safe in the arms of the Lord, and as pure as the day of her birth. My child given me faith in the future that's golden and new. My Mary will teach me to open my heart, and so I forgive you, Jew.
Bring in Jim Conley.
He told me to watch the door, watch the door. That's what he said, that's what he said. I should make sure no one came and interrupted. Well, I'd say once or twice a month, he tell me, Jim, you watch the door, I got a lady coming. I got a lady coming. Like I said, once or twice a month, there'd be a lady come to call. And he'd say, Jim, you watch the door, that's what he said. And once I remember, there were two ladies. Another time, there was this young black gentleman from Chicago.
Jackson. All right then, Jim, will you tell us about the morning of April 26th?
The day of the parade?
Uh-huh.
He told me to watch the door, watch the door. That's what he said, that's what he said. I got a girl, she'll be coming up to see me. She's a very pretty girl. He said, don't let me catch you looking at Miss Mary Perkins. Oh, that's what he called, I think, Miss Mary Perkins. So when this Mary came to call, I kept my eyes down to the floor, cause Mr. Frank said not to look, that's what he said. Next thing, I hear Mr. Frank yelling something, so I runs upstairs and I open the door, and Mr. Frank looks up. He said, we were playing a game, we're playing a game. That's what he said, that's what he said. And little Mary's kinda crumbled in the corner. He said, you don't understand. She didn't wanna play the game, and so I went and hit her. You see, I had to hit her. He told me I should go and look. He said, she's acting like she's sick. And I said, Lord, that child is dead. That's what I said. And he said, no, no, it ain't my fault that girl is dead. He said, no, no, that's what he said.
That's what he said.
He said, no, no. And his eyes were wild and his face was red. He said, no, no,
no,
that's what he said. Gotta get her out, let's get her out. That's what he said.
That's what he said.
And so I found me this old gunny sack and wrapped her. He said, you're a good boy, Jim. I know you won't tell no one nothing. Here's $100.
God, who can be true?
I got $100.
God, who can be true?
And so I put her on my back. We took the elevator down. He said, just throw her on the ground. That's what he said.
That's what he said.
Yes, he said, no,
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 no.
Thanks. No reason I should hang. He said, no,
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 that's what he said.
That's what he said.
He said, no,
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 there ain't no reason I should hang. You got money in your pocket, and there's plenty more of that. I got wealthy friends and family, and a wife who's dumb and fat. And I got rich folks out in Brooklyn if I need somewhere to go. And these stupid rednecks never go. No, no, hey, my hope that girl is dead. He said, no.
Thank you.
It's hard to speak my heart. I'm not a man who bears his soul. I let the moment pass me by. I stay where I am, in control. I hide behind my work, safe and sure of what to say. I know I must seem hard. I know I must seem cold. I never touched that girl. You think I'd hurt a child yet? I'd hardly seen her face before. I swore we'd barely met. These people try to scare you with things I've never said. I know it makes no sense. I swear I don't know why. You see me as I am. You can't believe I'd lie. You can't believe I'd do these deeds. A little man who's scared and blind, too lost to find the words he needs. I never touched that child, God. I never raised my hand. I stand before you now, incredibly afraid. I pray you understand.
This angel met her end on the concrete floor of the sweatshop, where she tore out away her childhood, fastening her laces to pencil caps for 10 pennies an hour. She died a noble death, not a splotch or a blemish upon her. Your Honor, I've done my duty. I have no apologies to make. There will be but one verdict in this trial. Guilty! Guilty. Guilty!
Gentlemen of the jury, have you reached a verdict?
Yes, sir. We have, Your Honor.
How say you?
Guilty.
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 Guilty. Guilty.
Guilty.
Guilty.
Guilty.
We'll be right back.
coming down from the north. It's coming up through the ground, and it's a funny old sound, 'cause it's a rumbling and a rolling.
And I bet I know why. See him on the train, see him on the bus. They never cared much about folks like us.
But now they're gonna pay attention, so they're gonna ask service, who won't do nothing that'll make you nervous, won't do nothing worth a look or a mention, and they won't ever pay attention.
They never say my,
they gonna say bring me my boots,
bring me my tea.
I bet you thought the slaves were free.
Mr. Frank, good for you, a lot of folks coming to get you through. Mr. Frank, ain't that grand? A lot of folks coming to take a stand. Mr. Frank, knock on wood, it ain't gonna do you no goddamn good.
I can tell you this as a matter of fact, that the local hotels wouldn't be so packed if a little black girl had gotten attacked.
Go on, go on, go on, go on.
They're coming now, yes siree.
'Cause a white man gonna get hung, you see.
There's a black
for standing in the shadows and staring at the walls, Leo. Fight them strong and proud. Pray your voice is loud, loud enough to make it through that door. What on earth have I been worried for? Soon I won't be worried anymore.
See, how can you say that?
No, do it alone, Leo. Now there's the right idea. Make me feel as useless as you always have. Do it alone, Leo. What could a woman do? After all, so many people love you. They're dancing in the streets, Leo. Only you know how to change the future now. No one knows the pain you're going through. No one else is suffering but you. I could be a quiet little girl and cook your little meal and swallow all I feel and bow to your command, or I could start to scream across the whole damn South and never shut my mouth until they understand. But I can't do it alone, Lord. I want you to come home.
Don't you think that's pretty music? Those fellas sure can play. This beat was really made for dancing. Yes, ma'am, that's pretty music. I could dance the night away. You can hear that song so sweet and true. But truth to tell, not half as sweet as you. Don't you think that's pretty music? This song sure makes you smile. Shame you don't visit here more often. Yes, ma'am, that's pretty music. Just to listen for a while. If your feet don't follow your commands, just put yourself in old Jack Slayton's hands. Who knows my style? That's it, that's right. A beautiful lady to dance a while. Seems you know what I need. I'll even take your lead. We're dancing, yes indeed. We're so light on our feet we can dance for miles. So don't you stop that pretty music. Sure makes me feel alive. If I could dance with you today, turn an ankle and let that music play.
I have heard them in the street. Governor,
justice, we have justice.
Through these old and tired walls, calling through the autumn night, but still more blood must flow. And I declared it so. And maybe I was wrong. Maybe what was obvious then would not have been for long. But I would not delay. And maybe I was right. Maybe I'm afraid that in a higher judge's sight I won't know what to say. So before I leave this world behind, I have to speak my mind. Hatred in the air. How is any man to know what is or isn't fair? I left it up to fate. It now may be too late. They'll be calling out to you, Governor. You will know what's right to do.
Oh, my sweet Lucille, how did you ever manage it? You don't know what any of this means. It means cancel all your parties. Forget your big parade. It means the crowds will not be cheering, so despite what you've been hearing, you can lay down your spade. It means my mother can't stop crying. My rabbi's eulogy can wait. It means that Dorsey can't stop beaming, and my cousin can't stop dreaming of his portion of my estate. It means no, this isn't over. No, the date's not set. No, I won't wake up tomorrow drowning in my sweat. It means I've got the greatest partner any man can get. It means I'll never, ever, ever underestimate that woman, 'cause this is not over yet. Tell my uncle not to worry, tell the reaper not to hurry, make the hangman stop his drumming, 'cause I'm coming into town to win the day. Somehow I haven't with my scheming screwed things up beyond redeeming, and we're finally on our way. And no, this isn't over. Hell, it's just begun. Hail the resurrection of the South's least favorite son. It means I took a vow for better, and two is better than one. It means the journey ahead might get shorter. I might reach the end of my rope, but suddenly loud as a mortar, there is hope. Finally,
yes, hope.
Isn't guilty, doesn't have to walk the plank. It means the gallows still are vacant, and we've got my wife to thank. It means you shouldn't underestimate Lucille and Leo Frank, 'cause this is not over.
Behind that wall,
yeah.
We're gonna roll like thunder. I'm gonna taste the morning, feel the rain fall. Hey, yeah. Hey,
yeah.
I'm gonna rise like sunshine. If I see her turn, I'm gonna rise like sunshine. I'm gonna sit down on her and feel the sun burn. Hey, yeah. Hey, yeah.
Hey, Jim. Got you a visitor, boy.
Hello, Jim.
You who I think you are?
Couple of questions for you.
You want some water? Bring the governor some water.
No, thank you.
We fixing to talk about that mess with Mr. Frank?
Yes.
Yeah.
When they found the body in the basement, coroner's report says there was sawdust in the mouth and lungs.
Hey, yeah.
Yeah.
Got any idea what that means?
Yeah.
Means she had to be breathing in the basement, because there isn't any sawdust on the second floor. Means she was alive when you carried her into the basement.
Then she must have come back to life, 'cause she was dead as last Christmas Eve when Mr. Frank showed me the body.
We're gonna roll like thunder.
Coroner's report raises some questions about your story, wouldn't you say?
That's so. You can try and prove that in court, I imagine.
You ever been on a chain gang, governor?
Not yet.
You ever break these rocks on a chain gang? Get yourself thinking, governor.
How you wanna have a good time?
Hey, yeah. Now, Mr. Frankie had a good time. Man knows how to have a good time. Hey, yeah.
Yeah.
I got a time with you.
rainfall.
Hey, yeah.
Yeah.
Hey,
yeah.
Hey, yeah.
Hey,
yeah.
Hey, yeah.
Hey, yeah.
Hey, yeah.
I have an announcement to make. Leo Frank is no longer a prisoner in the Fulton Tower. At 5 o'clock this morning, he was removed to another prison location, which will not be disclosed at this time.
Will you walk with your head held high?
Another governor lost his hands and turned to chew over to the
law. Or move aside when they're passing you by.
Another Jew went to his grave.
Will you run when the files are fed? And when the flood comes.
And I have decided to commute his sentence from the death penalty to imprisonment for life.
Will you ride by the side of God? Or will you hide in the soil and the sod? Will you fight for the soul of your land? Well, where will you stand when the flood comes? Where will you stand when the flood comes?
Mr. Dorsey, you care to comment?
I was not part of the governor's decision, Mr. Craig. I'm as surprised as you are.
Will you beg for the Jews' reward? Or walk with us at the side of the Lord?
Put your soul in the devil's hand.
Well, where will you stand when the flood comes?
Where will you stand? Where will you stand? Where will you stand?
With you, Mr. Watson, I'll be proud to stand with you.
God bless the next governor of Georgia!
I see through the fog and dust. So let the mob do whatever they must. Slayton jumps at the Jews' command.
Where will you stand when the flood comes? Where will you stand? Where will you stand?
And the news spread like wildfire. An angry crowd marched north on Peachtree Street toward the governor's mansion, yelling, "Hang the Yankee lover!"
See them laugh when an angel dies. See them
in Jewish stores. Jacob Seligman, a clothier, was beaten and left for dead.
Mary, Mary, the angel child, still your name and your soul are defiled. Thank God you can't hear the things they say.
But someone's gonna pay.
Someone's gonna pay. Someone's gonna pay.
I will never understand what I did to deserve you, or how to be the man that I'm supposed to be. I will never understand if I live a thousand lifetimes why you did the things you did for me. Just look at you. How could I not be in love with you? What kind of fool could have taken you for granted for so long? All the wasted time, all the million hours pushing you away, building up my wall. All the days gone by to glare, to pout, to push you out, and I never knew anything at all. I never knew anything at all.
I will never understand how all the world misjudged you, when I have always known how lucky I must be. I will never understand how I kept from going crazy, just waiting there till you came home to me. Now look at me, now that you're finally here with me. Now that I know I was right to wait and everyone else was so wrong for so long. All the wasted time, all the million hours, years on top of years, still too proud to cry. All the days gone by to feel that I don't satisfy, and I never knew anything at all. I never knew anything at all.
All the wasted time,
all the wasted time,
all the million hours, leaves too high to touch, roots too strong to fall.
Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem Kvod Malchuso Leolam fine. Here you'll see. Farewell, my
and you're holding my arm, and you're stroking my hair, and you're finally...
Mr. Frank?
What is it?
I caught a fight for these old hills behind me, these old red hills of home. I caught a fight for these hills that remind me of a way of life that's pure, of the truth that we're city of